Good evening, everybody, and welcome to Dark DJ Productions. And as you can see, we're doing a thing today. We're going to be doing a cab ride on the DR. So I'm just going to go grab some people. There they are.
Hello there.
Boink.
And they will be joining me on my magical journey flying through the sky today. So.
Right, shoot it down.
Oh. Okay.
Oh. Speak of the devil. Or the. Do we want to bring Gareth in, or...?
Yeah, go on then, whatever. So, I'm just sharing the stream to my group quick. So, yeah, sorry about that. I won't actually do something in a minute. The whole idea is that we're... Shut up, Chris. The whole idea is that we're going to be running down, from Merecombe to Barbourne, as the description kind of casually says. So, should be fun, I guess. And also, we get to sort of, look into the whole scenery updates I've been doing, which I must admit I'm pretty proud of. So Anthony and Chris, I'm going to get you guys in charge of the chat because I'm going to be closing the internet this time for this stream.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So, without further ado, let's jump in the cab. So we're driving 7070 today, Andy, and we're going, as I said, from Merecombe to Barbourne, which they distance off. 25.4 miles. So that's pretty long, schlong.
Hey. So what are we waiting for?
Memes.
Memes.
Oh.
Memes!
Oh, ahem.
What?
Happy birthday to Gothos Early, aka Amy. No, happy yesterday's birthday.
Oh, I can't be bothered with birthdays. Birthdays are evil.
I can't remember them either, but I just, you know. I'm a nice person, sometimes.
So we'll be predominantly sticking to the cab, but already at Merecombe, I have made a small change in... You'll probably see it coming up on the left-hand side. But I've been going around today putting signs on the signal box in to say what they are. Like, I know that seems a bit, you know, obvious what they are, but it's more for most on some railways, you do have, like, you know... For example, here you've got Merecombe North box to differentiate it from Merecombe South box, which is over here.
What do you mean?
What, Chris, what? Shut up.
I don't know what it means. Because, you know,
It's just a name on the station, on the signal box, just to identify what the signal box is.
Ah, okay.
Like, I mean, they're more for locations where, like, you know, junctions and whatnot, where there isn't a location nearby. Like, for example, like, I don't know, like, I'm trying to think of somewhere now. Let's say, for example, Gretna Green. The signal box might not be right next to Gretna Green station, but it would be Gretna Green signal box. Ah, that's okay. To identify it when it's away from a station.
Nice.
So, for example, we're now approaching Merecombe South box.
So why are you wrong? Oh no, you're not wrong roading.
I'm right roading, Cleb. The only place I'll be wrong roading will be at Kolhapa due to the changes I've been making there as well.
True. Oh, look, a shed.
Nothing in it though.
Yeah, it's not number 17 anyways.
Oh. But anyway, as you can see, there's a name board on more or less every signal box has a name board, so that one says Merecombe South box. So I just think it looks nice, you know? Just gives it a bit of extra customization, I guess you'd call it, seeing as I can't build proper custom assets. So, but yeah, this stream is predominantly going to be, you know, a slow meander down the DR.
Yay!
Also, is Gareth actually here, or is he just mute? Because if he's actually mute, then just pull him out. Yeah.
Gareth?
Looks like he's mute. Okay, hold on. I'll do that then. Anyway. So again, this is more a casual thing. It's not like there's nothing action packed going on. But
well,
there is,
I'm here.
Well, apart from that, I guess.
I've just started a thought. You know how engines talk to their crews? Is there like some sort of like secret walkie-talkie installed somewhere in every engine's cab where they can talk to their drivers?
No, I reckon a voice just boomed through.
Oh.
What does that mean? Like, right now we're hearing Andy Stewart going, "You're a fucking cunt."
Pretty much.
This is a little... Oh, get on the train, you little shits!
Honk.
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 By the way, if I stop, if I randomly stop talking, it's because I'm eating pasta.
Yummy.
Mmm.
Oh. Thomas's driver was a lettuce.
Don't eat me, Thomas. Anything changing on the chat? Usually I've got it to the side so I can read it, but...
Nothing special.
I'm so fed up of hearing the freaking Chrome notifications every time someone comments on a video or whatever.
Fair enough.
This dynamic weather effect really does work pretty well when you're sat in the cab.
What is it actually called?
It's like EK 3D cloudy. Scattered cloud? You got it with Exeter Kingsway anyway.
Yeah, I know. Just wanted to know the name. So can we all just appreciate how good the DR looks now compared to the 60s version? Sorry, I'm Rick there.
That was another reason why I was doing this stream in particular, Chris, because I wanted people to see how different this is to the 1916 version, for one thing, and just how much has improved since I've had the Black Knight. Like, scenery-wise, you know?
Yeah. It's funny enough, yes, that is true.
Hmm?
I was just reading what Goth was saying.
Well, what'd she say?
YouTube poop of TTT is funny as fuck. It's called responding.
Oh.
Oh, look at that. It looks like the weather's changing.
It might be.
Cheeky. More clouds are popping up and stuff.
Hmm. Well, I've got a bowl of chips as well now, so that's good.
Oh.
Oh, I see steam. That must mean one of my AI traffic coming through.
Oh no.
But what is it?
It's my train.
Oh, it's Hannah. Hannah.
Oh, it's Hannah. Never mind. My fucking cylinders! I see a freight train? What is that there? Did Abomination slack off again?
No. That's the thing, I love sitting in these scenarios and watching the weather change. I don't know if you just saw it while we're still. You'll probably see that the weather will change in a minute. Like the clouds moving in and out is quite pleasant. Ooh, those chips are hot. Never mind. Put some cold pasta in.
Matt the Terrier is driving Andy Diesel.
Hmm. I was hoping Andy would be around for this, but he does not appear to be. There you go, the weather's changing again now. The shadows, even.
I can see clearly now. Oh, never mind.
I can't see clearly at all.
Me neither. I lost my eyes. Back in numb.
Hey, let's go.
Wait, this train doesn't go weesh.
It might.
Oh, does it? Dun dun. What the twist?
Ooh. I've released the brakes and everything. Come on.
Standing still. He was feeling very frustrated with himself.
Somehow it moved itself back to neutral.
Oh.
I'm not quite sure how that happened.
Andy.
You know, that signal did not want to work for me. It's always red. It's like an overreacting red signal at Manston 4.
Overreacting red signal?
Yeah.
Wow. No one appreciates me.
Hmm.
signal. We love you. No, you don't.
Hi.
But rail buses are electric, aren't they? They are mostly, but this is a steam rail bus.
But is it?
Yes, they are. What are you up to then, son?
I like train.
Yes, you do. Hey, you know who's...
You know what? I just done that thing again.
Oh, I just saw that.
Like, seriously, the scenario is supposed to be set for me to go. Thanks for that. So now I've got to do all of that all over again. Stupid game. Well, I suppose I better put the loading screen back up then. That's annoying. That's incredibly annoying. I set it up specifically so it would be a nice clean run.
What does it do? Does the points just randomly switch?
Those particular points just don't seem to want to allow. I don't know why, because I've set a destination and everything. Nothing's set to go in there.
Weird.
Well, that's upset.
I'm guessing those abandoned trucks had right of way.
Well, it's just ruined my entire stream again. Getting quite fed up with this.
Maybe you need to take a look at the points there.
I will in a sec when it loads back up again.
Because it's only those points that does it, isn't it?
Yeah, but as I say, now that's ruined my... I mean, that's 12 minutes of video footage that's pointless.
Well, I wouldn't say pointless.
I would.
I mean, if you really want to, we could do a stream restart. I mean, it's up to you to in the end, but like...
Yeah, but it'll still keep this bit, won't it?
No, what I mean is you end the stream and you start it up again, delete this one, and, you know, all that stuff.
Yeah, can do.
However, you'd lose a few things, so... Yeah.
Well, whatever, I'll keep it. Oh, no, I won't, because, failed to save dump. Thanks, game. Piece of crap.
64-bit, please.
Yeah, tell me about it. Well, I suppose while we're waiting for it to load, I'll put something quiet on in the background. Great. Thanks, game. Piece of crap.
Yeah. This is why we needed 64-bit, like, years ago. I got scared for a moment there because my mom messaged me. Usually that means driving and picking people up. But she was just asking how windy it was over here. Luckily for me. So Chrissy gets to stay for the stream. Anthony bonked.
He bonked sheep. Oh.
Yay! I mean, what?
What?
See, the points look like they're actually set the correct way, so I'm not quite sure why it derailed me there.
Fucking knows, to be honest. I still think it's kind of weird, though. Like, why does it just randomly derail you?
I don't know, but I'm going to set my train up to be just past those points. Because they seem to be a bit troublesome, those points.
Sodor. Sodor. Somewhere.
Actually, hold on, they are. No, that's weird. They look like they're pointing the right way, so I don't get it.
I don't. That's a bit weird.
Well, we've done that section at least, so if I turn the music off. And turn off the loading screen. Let this thing go around one more time. So now we are back in the cab of Andy. That was quite annoying. I wanted this to be a straight run. To be fair, I might just record a video at some point. Like, I might just re-record this as an actual video. Perhaps.
Yeah.
Those points are so bizarre, though.
Yeah, I don't really get that.
Like, and there was no real reason for them to do it, either. They were set the right way, according to the scenario.
Real.
And it is a standard scenario I'm running, so... I don't know. How are people doing in the stream chat?
People are just, you know, talking.
Let me guess, not about what we're actually doing again.
This point, the points to Stranger Things, oh.
That would be a no, then.
Andy going on a field trip to Iraq.
Back it up. We don't even want to go there. Just back it up, back.
Now, for this section line, I think Upway Bank is probably one of my favourite bits now because of the amount of work that's been done here. Obviously, the main show is down at Beyond Cole Happer, but we'll see.
I mean, this line, part of the line is pretty cool.
Starting to think I might actually be turning into James Cameron. No, is it James Cameron or David Cameron? I don't even know which Cameron it is now.
One of them.
What are you on about?
Whichever one has the ego trip.
Oh, John Cameron.
John Cameron! I knew it was a Cameron!
How many cameras do you guys have over there? Jesus Christ.
You got James Cameron, David Cameron, John Cameron, Cameron Cameron.
You know what? Forget I asked.
Wait a minute. It's James Cameron's not British, is he?
No, he's not British, but we know of him. As in, he has the last name Cameron?
That's incredibly cheap.
So anyway, Upway Bank then, boys. What are you thinking? Is it a bank?
It's a bank, and...
Is it?
It's a bank, good. And there's trees.
Is there? I didn't realise there were trees. I thought they were bananas.
Trees of wood.
Redwood, too.
I see green
wood.
Branches.
Eating my banana, and I think to myself, what the fuck did I just say?
Pretty much.
I'm a bit weird, am I?
You are a bit weird, yes. That's why no one likes you.
I was gonna say that's why I go along so well with you guys, but never mind, fuck you. I see. Redwood too.
I hate the sounds on the Hi-Mex.
On my Andy.
Miami.
You were a fucking cunt.
Now come on guys, we got to be PG-13 now.
No, we don't.
Aw, okay. Wait. Let me get out and open with them. Cunt, shit, wank, bollocks, bastard, fucker. There you go.
Oh, I'm
everyone happy now?
No. I'm gonna cry now.
Awesome, go for it. Anyway, hello Upway, how are you today?
Hello.
I'm a station.
Hello, parking meter. Hello. I sense a little
Yeah, well, I've been to Upway Station. Not much has changed, but there are some wagons.
So why are those wagons rolling down the hill?
Because they're on a flat plane.
Oh.
I think you've run a bit short there.
Not really. Only a little bit short. I've only got a 6-coach train.
Tom! 9 of them are outside the platform! Wait, 9?
Chris, shut up. No one likes you, jeez.
I know.
Like, me and Anthony hate your guts.
Nice voice crack.
Oh.
They are mostly. This is a steam rail bus.
Your steam rail bus. In fact, Anthony's a steam rail motor.
Ew, no thank you.
Oh.
Motorboat him.
Right, that's enough waiting around it up. Wait, let's go. This time I made sure the reversal was set.
Yeah.
You watch, as soon as we leave the station, those points ahead of us will be set against us as well. Even though the signal is green, so we should be fine.
Troll points are trolly.
Rolly the troll points.
Rolly the troll points, he got derailed.
Rolly was depressed. Ah, fuck it, who cares?
Yeah. Oh, lads, I looked in the
mirror. And as I was saying about all the signal boxes, even Upway's signal box has a little sign on it that says Upway signal box.
What about Downway?
There is no Downway.
Oh.
There's only up.
There's up and there's down. But what about sideways? You really are a retard.
I'll tell you who is a retard though. Bob. Marley. Junior. The fifth.
The fifth. Hey!
As that person doesn't exist, I'm quite happy saying that.
Yay!
Although that Chris Rasmussen guy.
Oi!
He's a great friend, lovely person all around, and everyone likes him.
Aww, how kind.
In a parallel universe.
Oh, fucking. You dickhead. You actually got me there.
So, Barry, what's on your mind today? Barry? Barry?
Girl?
What's on your mind today?
Barry is love and Barry is eating.
Oh, a bit like me then.
Suddenly, Caracus's driver was a lettuce. Don't eat me, Barry. Bomb. But you're not chickens.
I love the way the sun suddenly pops out and then all the shadows suddenly turn up. It's lovely.
Oh, that looks so nice.
See, Woolchurch Bank doesn't look bad as well, actually.
It doesn't, no.
The better than it gives to, like, I mean, as I was saying, if you actually run DR-1916, in fact, once I've done this, I might go and set a scenario up to run on the DR-1916 just to show you the difference.
Yeah.
But the difference to everyone is just, like, night and day with this route.
More like night and day on Mars.
More like black night and...
white night.
Yeah.
White night!
White night is shooting up a... oh. Let's not say
if you
that.
You don't know what I'm talking about.
I'm gonna jump in and explain beforehand. White Knight with my laptop, Black Knight into the computer. Woo!
Oh, no, that's not what I was gonna explain.
Damn it!
I was gonna say, if you're above the age of 15, please be, go search up the White Knight and it's a cyanide and happiness kit.
Oh my god, please, Chris, don't start directing people to do things against their will. I had enough of that in college.
What?
That's true. I spilt my drink. Fuck you, Tom.
Oh god, me and Anthony are both at it.
Yeah, you fucking...
Anyway, if Andy happened to turn up at some point, drag him up.
Drag him in.
If anyone else turns up, they need to gain actual permission from actual me for actual joinisms.
Tom, the Queen's here.
Oh, bugger. I'm not having the Queen in here. She'll just laugh at my silly jokes.
So,
wool shirts.
That fucking foghorn, eh?
Oh, it's so damn loud.
It rattles my fucking ass. Oh, look, a train.
Oh, yeah, Chris, you might be interested in that certain train.
Happy boy!
Hey, up!
Hi!
Hey, up, Andy! Andy! Andy, please talk to me! Honk.
Honk.
Anyway, there are, I don't know whether we're going to be able to see it too much from here, but there are some changes here at Wolf Church.
I can see it.
What?
It's a bit grassy, isn't it?
Yeah.
I'm surprised that Barry's near trying to get to that farm.
Ew.
Barry's found another tactic.
Anthony, are you happy now? I stopped in almost the perfect position. In fact, I stopped perfectly, so shut up.
No.
Shut down. Ha! Fucking hell. Oh. There comes the scream, Tom. You happy now?
Barry's found a new tactic to get into that farm. He's going to air dive in.
Air dive?
Suddenly, Barry demolished the farm building.
Fucking AC-130 drops. Fucking.
Anyway, the main difference here, just while we jump out of the cab, is that because the goods yard at Wall Church is starting to be less and less used, it's starting to get a bit overgrown with weeds. Or, as Brian is hoping, actual weed.
I can see a farm.
Oh, shit. What up? There is a farm over there.
Is there?
He doesn't export anything by rail anymore, though.
Actually. Why wouldn't he? It's literally 5 foot away from his doorstep.
Well, he does it by lorry now, because with the DR being, like, not really a massive freight contractor anymore.
What a retard.
I love how I just heard Anthony, Anthony Cutlery clink down, and as he did that, oh, it was you, was it? Okay, well, as you clink that piece of cutlery, that's when I pressed the button for Andy to start going.
Oh, nice.
Lol. Anyway, off we go. Where's Andy?
That's Anthony. He's scraping the cutlery.
Oh my god, who? I don't even know. God, jeez. Someone help me.
Okay. Bend over, I'll stick your finger up here. Wait, what?
Bend over and touch your toes. I'll show you where the monster doesn't go.
Yeah.
Because this is clearly a family-friendly cab ride, isn't it, Chris?
Well, it's not going to be a cab ride for long.
If you know what I mean. Wink, wink, nudge, nudge.
Oh, shit. Well, to be honest, I don't think this is going to be a cab ride for a tiny little bit now.
Why?
Because you're probably going to take a screenshot at the viaduct.
Nope.
Oh my god!
I'm sticking by my guns. The only place I'm going to get out is when we're stopped at stations. I'm a professional driver, Chris.
Yeah,
what do you take me for?
There's like a golden rule on this where you always have to take a screenshot when you go with the viaduct. Are you alright?
Well, I'm going to break that rule today, everyone. I'll find out in the comment section who actually cares, to be quite honest. Like, you know, how many people are defiant about the fact that I'm not going to take a picture on the viaduct?
Well,
oh,
I'm
by the way, Chris,
cause
what do you think of the viaduct? Yeah. Anyway, it's lovely. It's actually really nice driving across it from the driving point.
Is it just me, or is Andy scraping along the viaduct right now?
Yeah, it's a little bit tight, isn't it?
Yeah, I think you need to move that viaduct the slightest bit to one side.
Damn it, Eustace.
Yeah, it's Eustace's fault, remember?
Yeah, I know that, but like, look at the gap on the teeth on the right side.
Oi! Well, Chris, joke's on you. There still isn't a platform at Lake. We've got a running joke, basically, that Chris lives in Lake, which is just over here. And, hang on.
I see my house. It's the yellow one.
Yellow one.
Or a beige-looking one.
Okay. But anyway, as you guys know, there used to be a station here at Lake. Since it's gone, Mr. Ramperson's had to walk into Wolf Church in order to get a train. But there's no road in at Lake. Your car's still in the shop at Horton.
Why haven't you moved it out yet?
Because it needs more work.
It's not my fault I banged the clutch a little bit too softly.
Well, you shouldn't have been drag racing at Cole-Happer, should you?
Well, you challenged me, you fucking cunt.
My car still works, thank you very much.
Fuck you. Hey, I still won it. That's $100. Or, well, 100 quid.
Well, $100 you can have.
It's like the Roadrunner IRL. It doesn't fucking work.
Jeez.
Oh, that's another thing I thought about.
Mm-hmm.
Because if I move up north, that means I'll have time to work at the Oldsmobile in my free time.
How many cars are you actually having?
4.
Can I have one?
Yes.
Can I have the Roadrunner?
Hell no.
Aww. Oh, nice. I see a train coming.
Oh, do you?
Mm-hmm.
Where?
Down the hill.
I can't see it. Oh, I see some coaches, though. Is that a train?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, it's steam. Oh, no. Is that who I think it is? Anthony? Oh, no.
Hello!
I love when you said that. It was like, as... What the fuck?
What?
Failed to save dump file.
It's still going.
I know. But I'm not gonna... The scenery's not gonna load or anything. Okay. Oh. I'll tell you what.
Stop at Axley and save.
Yeah. What do you reckon if I save, it'll let me load it back up?
Yeah.
Oh, wow. Okay. But if it fails after that point, I'll just load at the next station with a what's it called consist. Without any AI or any stuff down. I should have done that in the first place, actually.
Yeah. Alright, so to the people watching, we need to do this old style now.
So yeah, some of the scenery is going to look a bit weird for a minute till we get to Axley. Actually, why don't I just stop here quick?
What's that thing floating in the sky over there?
I don't know.
You see it, right?
What, on the left hand, on the right hand side?
Yeah.
Part of the windscreen.
Oh. Oh.
You can see what's failed to load here, can't you? Look.
Yeah.
The support for the bridge.
Try saving it.
Well, I've got to stop. Hang on. I'll stop here. In fact, I've got an idea.
Do you?
We can stop at Axley Signal Box and report at Soma Junction Signal Fox. We can report a dump file and then get permission to proceed on our merry way.
God damn it, Tom.
Oh, doesn't matter. We've, the emergency brake came on. So we're going to save here quick. We are going to put the BRB screen up. Well, loading screen even. I do apologise for this, everyone. I tried to make an interesting scenario and I failed miserably.
Oh.
Because there's supposed to be another piece of AI that we pass at some point, so... Right, so we saved it, so we can exit now. This game is incredibly unstable, I must tell.
Ah, well, about less than a month ago and it may be fixed.
Fingers crossed. Well, while we wait. Put some music on quietly while we wait for it to reload. Oh. And I can finish eating my pasta, actually.
Yay!
So I definitely think, guys, what I might have to do is try and rerun this as a single video at some point.
Probably.
Probably without the AI traffic, though, I reckon.
How about we eat...
I don't think we should.
Barry will be sad.
Oh, by the way, you probably heard in the background, I just decided to check online. You'll probably have heard the stupid diddly-dee sound again.
Is it saying, oh my god, I'm your biggest fan, can I call you Tom?
No, but I'm just having a read of some of the humans, some of the comments. Not many relevant ones at the moment, to be fair. So, I need to remember how I restart, like, how in a scenario. I have to go into drive, I think. Is there a way to mute Chrome? I just realised I can, can't I?
Oh, yeah, you can.
Open volume mixer. Chrome is now muted. Oh. So... Oh, yeah, I better point out I've got a cold slash chest infection. So if anybody's wondering. God, come on, you stupid computer.
No, said the Black Knight. I
Don't
won't.
Go away. Resume. Yeah, I would like to apologise to everyone for the amount of cock-ups this has already given me. Like, and it's weird, isn't it? When I'm just mucking about on a stream, the stream goes fine. But as soon as I want to do anything planned, or anything just really nice and smooth, the game decides, you know what? No.
Nope.
Not having it.
It's probably because of the recording / streaming loaded with the scenario.
Maybe. Hopefully it went too long to load up again. Chris, no one cares that you like Green Day, by the way.
I do.
No, not allowed. Oh, come on, load.
Anthony.
Hmm?
Look at stream chat.
No.
You.
You're a unit of power, Harry.
I'm a what?
Fuck you, Tom.
Oh, good news.
What?
Well, the scenario seems to have loaded back up again.
Sweet.
So just let that finish running round.
Sweet home on the DR. Get a little of them. Lord, I'm coming home to you.
So let's try again, shall we?
Weesh!
The signal was red. Oh.
Oh.
Oh. Suddenly the Eno appeared. Meow.
I'm back at Soma! So what might I have to do, every single station stop now, I'm going to save the game, just in case. Because I'm determined to finish this run today, boys and girls.
Suddenly derails that actually. Right, fuck this!
Yeah, fuck this, I'm going home. But in all seriousness, I don't know, I like the way the DR looks now. It looks much better than it used to. Oh, here we are, it's Soma Junction signal box finally has an identifier.
Yay.
When's the sunlight gone?
Oh.
I'll come back now, I think.
I just thought, actually didn't have a bridge on the 60s route, did it?
No, that was because the bridge was put in like, oh, I can't remember when the bridge was actually put in, but we'll have a look back at some point. But a road was built to Soma, wasn't it? Like a smaller road was built to Soma. Don't know why the signal was red. Please tell me there's no points locked against me. Yep, there was. Right, fuck dish!
Yes!
Why is that happening? I don't understand. I think there's only one way I'm going to be able to do this now. Because I was really hoping it was just going to work. It is literally going to... I'm literally thinking I'm going to have to write like Andy in the signal. Where were we? We were at Axley, weren't we? So let's see, let's delete that scenario, because clearly it doesn't love me. The nearest station in Gannon Junction, so I'm going to have to do some setting up, I'm afraid.
Kinky.
Oh, it's so annoying. So what I'm going to do then, because I'm getting annoyed, I'm going to BRB. I'll go for a puff. So I'm going to put some music on in the background again. Chris and Anthony are going to try and keep you entertained for a minute. Really sorry, everyone, by the way. You know how annoyed I get with this.
We'll keep him entertained. Time to do some self-plugging.
Okay. Oh, for God's sake.
I'm kidding.
Everybody subscribe to Steaming Westwood Productions.
Right, anyway, while I BRB and wait for this stupid game to load, enjoy the music, everyone. Enjoy Chris's antics and Anthony's antics. BRB.
Hey, that rhymed. Right, now that we're here... What do you guys think of the new DR so far? You think Tom's done a good job, or you think it looks completely govno, which is shit in Russian? I personally think it looks pretty good. There's still work to be done, but you know, that's whatever, Root. Anthony didn't reply to this because he didn't have shit to say.
No. Oh. You know me, Chris, I'm not good with words.
I know, that's why I'm talking and you're not.
You're the one, that's why you're head of Tom's PR.
I'm the social one, I'm the one with social anxiety. Good one.
Yeah, you're the social one, I'm the nerd. Callum's the...
crazy one.
Yeah, why not?
Not bad crazy, good crazy.
And Oliver is the upside down one.
Yeah. Nah, Goff can keep going, don't worry about it. I'll be purple, even though you have the same name as Tom. So, I have a dog. Suddenly, 10 people are interested.
Suddenly, 10 people have left the stream.
You get, I'll agree. That, yeah, I do have a dog, Matt. Matt, stay the fuck away from him. Anyways, no. We all know that I have figured out the secret to DR. The fact that it's a railway in Kent.
Oh, I'm outraged. Why would you build anything in Kent?
I don't know. Same reason you'd build any Ivets, you know? Just to piss people off because they're so shit.
Right. Come on, Chris. Round the back.
Oh, shit. Also, to do a little bit of pushing up some stuff here, if you guys haven't already, go watch the trailer for the Halloween special of this year that's out on Tom's channel. It's a bit back, maybe, I don't remember. But really, go watch it. It's quite interesting. And then you, of course, have to wait until Halloween to see the full thing, but it's worth the wait. Haven't seen. Oh, that's kinky.
Well, I'm sorry, Kane, but it's not Pornhub.
Yeah. Oh. Fun fact: did you know that today is tomorrow if tomorrow was today?
Boom. Anthony's head exploded with this realization.
Yes, indeed. And so, Chris blew up the DR.
Why do we never talk about trains in Norway?
That's quite simple. Two reasons. One, the trains that were actually built by Norwegians are crap. Two, the other ones that we have are German. Like the modified Kriegsland, which is called Trolls.
Yeah, I think Norway's only two actual good trains got nicked and brought over to the UK.
Yeah, the Norwegian and Kongholm.
Or it's just now sat in Breslin dressed up as an American train and absolutely filthy.
Yeah. Yeah, Gotham City actually knows some Norwegian. Why are we talking about cleaning products, odd? If you mean the Sami people, then yeah. Well, Autumn, if you want to talk to Matt about it, or not, if you want to talk to Matt about it, you can find it in the DMs. And please don't start a hissy fit over people being people in this chat, people. People can be who they want. Unless you're trained, then you're bio-abused, and I'll turn you into a truck and let you not have a mouth.
But, Chris, I've not been troublesome. You can't do this to me.
It's fine, Tom. I like how people are jumping into Google translating I love trains into Norwegian. You get one clap.
No, Barry's not here. Barry's on strike.
Yeah,
he's on strike until he figures out how to get into that farm at Wall's Church.
Well, he did, remember?
I'm sorry, that has to be a running gag in season 9. Just like Barry trying to break into this farm.
Yeah. We have seen how we can do it, but that's on my channel. It's unlisted. It's just for a shitty joke. If you're on the Discord server, you can ask me to post it again and I'll do it. It was probably the emojis on them, but you know, moving on. I'm gonna post something in the chat now. And everyone is gonna panic.
Right, I'm back.
Oh shit, Tom's back. Run away.
But I'm leaving the music running and stuff for a minute because I've got to set up actually.
True.
I'm really annoyed about this.
Well, it's not your fault.
I just don't understand why the points all switched against me. I've got a clear rundown. But there's nothing in the way. So I don't understand why it's doing this to me. All I wanted to do was show everyone the route, you know what I mean?
Yeah. Think about it this way, Tom.
Although I have got something else to think about. At least while I'm loading up this thing, I get to listen to Time Wasted.
True. Anthony?
Which I think the only person who actually likes it is probably Railway Productions.
What, Time Wasted?
Yeah.
I like the design. I'm headbanging to it.
I actually realised, going listening back to, because you remember I was listening to Alive 1997 earlier on.
Yeah.
I realised actually how much I'm influenced by two particular Daft Punk tracks, and that's Rolling and Scratching and Rock and Roll. But yeah. This is literally like, this is almost exactly the same as those two. The good thing is as well, yeah. I was just going to say, by me setting this up as a free roam again now, it means I can run round at the end of the line at Barbourne. So let's get Andy again, because we're going to keep our Andy Diesel.
Alright, I'll pull him up from AFK.
Oh, this might work actually, hold on. If I can set this up quickly enough, I might be able to put Andy down before the end of the song.
Sweet. Kane, you'll have to wait and see, like Top Hat Fellow said.
What's this?
Kane asked if, you can see it properly.
If see what? Oh, what I'm doing right now? Or the Halloween thing?
Yeah, the Halloween thing. Like, if Thomas Leander alive in Elementary School, it's just like, wait and see.
Oh, right. Well, yeah. It's a case of wait and see. Just double check my points. Now I'm going to have to double check my points all the way down.
Spoilers, though. It turns out Leander was actually me the whole time.
Clearly. Fuck. What? A fan of the BR standard QMTs and keep the Valley Railway red.
Well, thankfully, my act means I can do this.
Oh, that worked out so well. The song ended just as I was actually ready to do this. That is brilliant. That was an excellent filler song. Anyway, I am going to have to stop at each station and check the points ahead of me now.
Just fucking move.
But yeah, as regards to the Halloween special anyway, people are just going to have to now wait and see. It's only a month away, everyone, don't worry. But I'm hoping it's worth the wait, if I'm quite honest. Because I showed my dad, and, well, my dad's, like, really ill at the moment. He can hardly walk, he's having to use a crutch. He needs his hip operation badly. But I showed him, he chuckled for some reason. I asked him after I wanted it. I was like, Dad, what are you laughing at? He was just like, oh, I found, some of your voice work quite funny. I was like, Dad, leave me alone. I'm like, I literally am one man band on this one. because of the secrecy of it, it had to be a one man band episode.
Yeah.
But anyway, the good news is the game, we are now at a section of the line which I actually still quite like now, which is now the scenery I've updated between Axley and Gannon Junction looks a lot better. Man, I really do need to start. I need to put myself in Gannon Junction Railway Museum because I am becoming an ego trip on this route, aren't I?
An ego Della trip.
Oh. I need to go on a Della trip, yeah. Oh, by the way, just so everyone knows, I need to mute my mic a sec. The reason I had to mute my microphone because I had a really big pump. I could feel it
You're
through.
Disgusting.
I didn't want everyone to have to listen to it. Well, that reminds me. Someone said about October 11th. Who cares about October the 11th? October the 14th, I'll be at Swanage for the gala because they're having a Black Five as well. Yes!
Yawn. Black Fives are bad.
Go away, Chris.
What Black Five?
44871 is apparently going to the Swanage Gala on the 12th to 14th. So, Anthony, fuck your college course. You've got to come down.
Sorry, I don't want to, like, sit in the support coach all day.
You won't sit in the support coach. You'll be sat, well, you'll be sat on my lap. Wait, what? No. I'm joking. No. To be fair, hopefully 257 Squadron will be running again.
He's running the day before today. You go there. No, he's not running today.
Oh, fuck!
Real quick though, William the First, whatever. Can we guys talk about Norwegian's team? I don't actually know anything about Norwegian's team, and I live in Norway.
Do you know why that is, Chris?
Some shit.
Because Norwegian's team is Norwegian.
Yeah, it is. I only know about Troll, which I've been in, and it's a massive fuck. Kong Håkon and the Norwegian. Those two are in England.
Why are we having a history of, why did I just see someone plonk in a history of Halloween? It's like, all like I only use Halloween to write, supernatural and spooky stories. What do you two honestly, like, creep factor anyway? What would you say, considering the limitations we have, as we're doing a railway simulation, I'm using a railway simulator to write a series about talking trains. And the fact all I've got to... I'm still learning on After Effects and Premiere. What do you guys think is the creep factor of what I've managed to be able to achieve within those limitations for Mere Anarchy?
If you're putting it on a scale of 1 to 10...
Actually, I'm thinking 1 to 15.
Oh, fuck's sake. No, let's do 1 to 10.
Okay, go on then.
I was thinking around a 7, 7.5.
Right. So which is fair, which is fair.
Yeah.
I don't think. I think it's perfect, but I'm hoping that it's the amount of build up I'm giving up to it, and the fact it is only 9 minutes long. I'm hoping that that 9 minutes, well, I say 9 minutes, but let's put it easily, like the bulk of the episode is clearly only about 6.5 minutes. But
well, I don't want to give anything away. That's the problem. I want to talk about it, but I'm not gonna. Not gonna give it away.
Yeah, that's my problem.
I'm just saying, like, there are certain parts in there that had me like sliding down in my seat.
Oh,
fuck's sake! Why does everyone take everything sexually? I mean, like, afraid.
Oh, I'm sorry, but yeah, I think it's more the fact that, like, obviously you guys will see it when it comes out, but. We'll see.
Okay.
Oh, here we are at Gallons of Junctions.
Uh-oh. Wait, is that the museum?
Yeah.
Wait, is that a train?
There's nothing in there. There's nothing on the scenario. That's what annoyed me.
Oh, yeah, right. Yeah, right. I thought the chimneys were trains. Oh, look, here comes that trains gender guy. I like trains.
No. Wow, look, nothing. Digital style.
So... Explain again, Tom. Why does the DR need palm trees?
Just looks nice.
Oh, fair point.
Oh god, come on,
oh, you know, this is the expansion of Dark Railway. This is, Othaniel Darkwall.
Oh no! Oh! Guys! I went past the signal! I'm a disappointment! Anyway, should we get out here and have a look around? Oh my goodness, I hate when I press 8 and this happens. Man, that dude is really leaning forward, isn't he? He really got a bad back.
Yeah. Let me look.
What are you looking at?
William the First, if you can see what I put, that should answer your question. I'm not giving away my address.
I'm gonna give away your address. You live at 123 Fake Street. Actually, hang on, Chris and Anthony, can you just do me a favour here? Because I'm pretty sure last time I did a stream, Autumn K said something about how I'm single, and it's like... I don't know how many times I have to say that I'm not single.
Yeah, he does have a fiancé.
I have a fiancé. We've been together nearly... Well, in January, it would have been 10 years.
Yeah.
There is a Discord, but due to ongoing security things and stuff like that, we don't really invite people to the server that much anymore. Especially seeing if the chats we keep seeing on the live stream chats don't seem to go anywhere. And we keep getting the same thing happening on Discord server, to be quite honest, to be perfectly frank. I never did. I never checked the point work.
Another thing we need to point out is that we have had a bit of a squeak streak going on, and we really don't want to increase that.
So basically, cheeky breaky, let's get squeaky.
Yeah, so if you're like 13 and under, and
oh,
you
damn
have
it.
A squeaky voice.
Just... You know what, as I haven't actually shown anyone yet, we haven't stopped long enough. That's what I'm on about one of these new thing I'm doing with the signal boxes. So now you've got an actual sign that reads what the signal, where the signal box is and what it is. So I just wanted to show you that.
Alan, tell me you've failed in your job as a proper driver.
I know, right? I feel incredibly moist. Wait, that's not right.
I was going to say...
Oh, yeah, Buckeye, yes, we blame you completely. That's
no,
why
we
the only...
Don't.
That, well, I do, we do, because he's the only person
no, we
who's...
Don't.
We do, because he's the only person on warning.
No.
Well, to be fair, there's a bunch of people on there that we really do need to keep an eye on.
Yeah.
The Austerity Engine. Halloween special where Alan crashes into one of the characters' Smash Limited workshops and unleashes Project BB.
Oh, I Big wish. Oh, mate, I wish.
I was going to say, though, to some...
To somebody! Sorry, Kyle.
It's just... Literally, it's not been fun. Because we've had to, one, retreat to other channels because people are way too squeaky and have absolutely horrible microphones.
We've also had problems with people clogging up chats with pointless chit-chat.
Yeah, so we've had to divert those chats into other, you know, rooms. It's like we like interacting with you guys. We love talking to you guys. Well, some of us do.
Speak for yourself, I was going to say.
Yeah, I knew that.
Lol.
Like, honestly, like, some of us like talking to you guys and getting to know you. But when people do that, it throws us off.
Yeah.
We really want it to be serious, structured, and you know, we have a joke.
To be honest, like, I'm one of these people, I would love it from time to time if I could have a... Like, this stream right now, what I'm doing, showing you guys the scenery updates to the DR, because at the end of the day, this is for you guys in benefit, because you're getting sneak peeks of how the line's going to look next season. But I don't feel like many people take it that seriously. It's like, when I like try and initiate a serious chat sometimes, and we don't get one, like... That's why there's a serious discussion board on the Discord server that it only gets used only slightly, because most people I find it bizarre that people want to join the servers and stuff, but then they're not interested in what I'm doing, and it's a bit like why are you so keen to join the Discord then in the group if you don't want to like you don't want to understand really what's going on? Does that make sense?
Like if you just want to go into the Discord server to have a fuck about and invite the people that are interested in talking to you and do that on another server, then keep it serious on there, you know? Aw, Matt, that's so nice.
And Railway Productions has noticed the nice thing, this section isn't as closed in between...
Yeah.
Which I like the mix between open and closed. Like, as you'll see later on, guys, when we get down towards... the section, I think, is beautiful between Hitch and Abbas and Barbourne North. Because there is I think I said in the last stream, there is actually a, a section that I've, a story behind the reason why we're only going to a place called Barbourne North rather than into Barbourne Town. And I'll explain that more later on. But I've just noticed another question from Amy, aka Goth of Dirty Tank. How far am I into production next season? I'm not. This is like the part of the year where I take a break from it, especially seeing as I've just had me up and everything. So I am taking a bit of a break from production, but there's still stuff like the route editing is important because that's background stuff that doesn't, you know, that's stuff that I need to do in the background between seasons. I mean, look here. I don't know if you can see the new trees I've put in, like the little pines and stuff.
And we go single track here.
Yeah, that was something I'm going to say. I don't know whether you guys have noticed, Chris, but... The line that BR had that ran up to the DR, they've taken it up. Because
sorry, Claren.
There is still a connection to the... No, there's still a connection to the DR, like, further up past the station, but they didn't need the connection at this point because no traffic from BR going beyond Catacol Happer now. Like, even the freights, they don't really go through Kolhapa now. But as you can see, looking on this side, the line is all overgrown. And, I mean, I need to edit the platform at some point to make it, like, no less people on it. But you can see as well, as we're coming up to it, you've now got the end of line signal there, like, halfway up the platform. And I think that that sort of looks... It looks a bit more, you know, as it might have actually looked at an interchange BR station. Because you've got the DR side, which has the loop and whatnot.
Yeah. You can see as well, if you go a little bit further, there's a lot of overgrowth.
Yeah, because BR just aren't looking after it. And the DR, like, this section beyond the Kolhapa in the present time period, isn't really used that much. Because with the fleet being diminished so much as well, not many engines really can be bothered to sleep at Kolhapa.
True. Anyways, looking aside from unnecessary questions, I was gonna say my room, but then I got out. No. I was gonna say, what I could do for you guys that are interested and are actually serious about wanting to have serious discussion in Discord and not clog it up.
No.
I could post my Discord, like, name in the chat. You guys can send me a PM asking if you want to do, like, asking for the invite. And I'll give, like, a one-day link.
Yeah.
If Tom is okay with it.
Oh, by the way, just so everyone knows, if anyone's wondering why I've not actually answered it yet, because I've decided from this point onwards I'm not answering Kane's question because they're stupid. So, sorry. But, yeah, I really like the way this looks. Like, if you're looking at the stream now, like, the way that the BR side is literally... Because they're not looking after it and they don't care that much about Kolhapa Station. It's becoming overgrown and whatnot, but the DR side is relatively okay. And also, look, yay, Kolhapa East Box. Woo!
Oh.
Again, more stuff that we're, you know, adding. But anyway, let's carry on.
Yeah, anyways, I'm going to post my Discord name in the chat. You can add me and message me asking for the link, and if you're serious about it, I'll hook you up. But just saying, new people we keep a close eye on, and if they do too many stuff, they'll be kicked for, like, a while.
And they'll be eaten as well.
And then if they're sorry and they want to come back, they can try one more time. But after that, no more. So, yeah, there's my name on Discord. If you want to get into the server, just message me.
So Buckeye's asking if the DR will ever expand even further. Well, this is what I'm showing you now, because... During the series, like, I mean, I know we've seen down to Hitchin Abbas before, but the scenery updates make it look better. But, you know, the DR will eventually go beyond Kolhapa. But I was thinking a while ago that, like, the whole thing with Kolhapa's yard would be that it would be demolished and put at Barbourne if we had the big station at Barbourne. But as we don't, I think it's interesting because Kolhapa kind of becomes a hub. If that makes sense, like... You've got, eventually, we might get the Horton bit. We might get the Horton line. We'll have the what is technically a branch line to Barbourne. And then the main line up to Merecombe. All I can hear is someone typing, by the way. Chris, stop it.
Sorry, I have to.
No, you don't. But that means that Kolhapa would be like the starting point for, like, at least two of three different lines. Does that make sense?
Mm. Yeah.
So again, probably little detail people haven't noticed much because I don't think people are paying too much attention, but I've edited some of the trees around Kolhapa as well. And there's a new signal box here at the Kolhapa West box, because this is the one that controls this end of the loop, this crossover and the junction to Horton.
You planted two trees, austerity.
I planted many trees. Yeah, the whole idea really is that, like, the BRU's that side and the DRU's is this side. Even though there's a plethora of crossovers, and I need to signal this side for dual, like, you know, as it's like, where this reminds me of, and I might, I'm actually quite tempted sometimes to leave it as it is. This reminds me of the, Bar Valley. Because the Bar Valley run up a parallel track on the main line, a little way. But obviously what will happen is this secondary line here will be removed soon. If railway production is all about the bit just beforehand, that was a station at one point, and it might well become one again. It might become Coalhapper West. But
The track that veers off to the left, that's up to Horton.
Yeah, that line up there, over there, under that bridge that we're looking at now, that's the line that goes to Horton. And the line we're on now is the one that goes up the infamous Coalhapper Tunnel up to Bramley Parkway. But as you can see, this section of line is purposely built like this because my envisioning is that in 1973, which is the year we're at now, this section of the line will be closed and ripped up. So if the DR wants to buy it up and rebuild it, there's a lot to do. Like, they're going to have to rebuild this entire line. And also, they've got to recondition that tunnel. Because, as you can tell, this used to be a double-track main line.
I remember the meme of this tunnel.
Yeah. But this used to be a double-track main line, but I've left it in such a way that if we ever do decide to double it, we can redouble the line. But as far as I'm concerned, it may well be that the tunnel is just too... it'd be too expensive and too dangerous to recondition the other tunnel.
So they'd rather tear it down?
Well, no, it'll just stay there, but it'll be unused. It'll be bricked up. So there might even be an engine in there. So if we ever need to introduce a character in the future, we can always say it was bricked up in Coalhapper's other tunnel.
Gee, I wonder where I've heard that one before.
Oh, I know, right? But like the whole idea with this section is that they have to rebuild the railway in section from Coalhapper to probably a platform at Coalhapper West, maybe even a small interchange, and then you'd have the line between there and Bramley Parkway, where we might still build the Bramley branch. I'm not 100% on that yet. I'm still not sure if I'm going to build it yet. And then when you get to Bramley Parkway, that becomes like another branch. And shuttles well up there. And then from Bramley Parkway, they go down to... They originally want to go all the way to Hitchin Abbas, but they build a station at Manning's Heath Country Park, on the outskirts of Manning's Heath Country Park instead, and loop that as well with two platforms. Then they get to Hitchin Abbas, and then they're like, right, okay, from here, our plan is to go to Barbourne's main station and reconnect to the docks. But when they get there... When they get as far as they want to build, they realise, actually, like, they get into discussions about buying the land, and they realise they can't buy the land because it's already been entrusted to housing development. So, the whole idea of this section is that they get so close to reconnecting the old whole entire... Because the whole idea, in Zeke's mind, is that he wants to rebuild the entire line and then double it afterwards, so they've got, like, a reason. But now, after that happens, I think he realises... that he'd been putting too many resources into building up the railway and not enough on his fleet and coaches and whatnot. I don't know. I mean, we'll think about it. And yes, this is a long tunnel. It's a 2-mile long tunnel. It's one of the longest in fictional preservation. And it's a cheat as well, because... Sorry, Chris, I'll let you go in a minute, but...
No, go.
A cheat so that I don't have to do all the scenery for this section as well.
Lazy kid.
Anyway, carry on, Chris, sorry.
I was going to say, another thing about the whole Zeke spending or investing all his money into...
Buying land and rebuilding it, yeah.
Yeah. After a while, that's going to earn him up better. But it's about a balance. You always need to have a balance between spending and earning.
Well, yeah, because his argument is that if he rebuilds it all the way to Hitchin Abbas and Barbourne or whatnot, it's more financially better for them. But at the end of it, you've got to realise that there's actually more to running the line than just having a longer running line, because at the moment the railway is going to be 25 miles long. But it's interesting the way this pans out, because I've got a choice. Either I can leave it the way it is, which is where there's, like, the line Well, I've got three choices, really. Keep it the way it is, which is double track from Merecombe to Barbourne, Merecombe to Cole, and then single track from Cole to Barbourne. Or I can have the DR get singled in order to rebuild the track to Barbourne, like reuse the track from the double track. Or I can have it that we eventually double the line to Barbourne, but it seems a bit pointless doubling the line all the way to Barbourne when there's only a... Well, you'll see. But what do you what do you guys think? Like, not just you two up here, but the guys in the chat as well.
I like the line. Like, I've run... I think I've run all the way to Barbourne, actually, using TeamViewer.
Yeah.
Yeah, I did. Yeah, this is before he, you know, completely scenerized it. But I like the longer run after Cole Happer. Because... Imagine
it does actually it does actually feel longer, this section, doesn't it?
Yeah, it does. That's the thing. Like, imagine the DR1960s, because a lot of people have it.
Yeah,
it's like the DR1960s is well balanced. You have hills, you have straights, you have curves, you have it's very, you know, it has everything basically. That's why I like testing new engines on it. But it's like a DR plus basically what this thing is. Especially this section right here.
Well, yeah, because I'm looking, I'm moving the camera over to the right. What you'll see is the abandoned line to Bramley, because from Bramley Parkway, which is the station we are to going to next, this section all the way to Barbourne Docks was originally part of the Bramley and Barbourne Railway, and it originally connected the town of Bramley, which is over that bridge, to Barbourne in the south. But when the South Eastern and Chatham Railway came along, they bypassed, they made the Bramley Parkway a parkway, and they extended to Cole Happer to join up with their other line at Cole Happer, making it a through route. So, the Bramley branch line became less important because most, like, after 15 came along, people had cars and whatnot. So, I've used the wrong platform, I don't care. They had cars and stuff, so they just drove to the station. Or drove anywhere else, but there is a bus service that runs here. But I think Bramley Parkway is a nice station because it's, I like the offset platforms for one thing.
That looks nice. To be honest, I really like Hitchin Abbas.
Yeah, Hitchin Abbas is my favourite place on the line. Like, Hitchin Abbas station I like, and I like the embankment after Hitchin Abbas over the River Hitchin, as you guys will see soon, because that's a beautiful section now. Because that's the main bit I wanted to show everyone. That's why I did this run.
Yeah.
But if I just hop out of the cab for a minute, well, I'll show you what I mean about the staggered platforms. As you see, platform... what is that? That's the down platform, which is the one we should be in, is longer on this side, but it's shorter at the top because of the way it's staggered. The up platform, which is this one, is longer on this side. As you can see, they're provisioned that this used to be a junction station because you can see that there seems to be a platform here, and you can see the old track bed over to Bramley. And if I zoom over there, actually, you can see the track bed over to Bramley Town, which is over here, like further up anyway. But that's something I might build later on or leave. I mean, like, I actually kind of like the idea of leaving it as it is because, I don't know, I like the idea of this bridge structure just being there. And then, like, there being no, like, being open to walkers, like, a bit like the real-life Castleman's is for me. But, anyway, that's just me being, whatever. I like discussing my plans for the DR, but as someone said earlier on, like, about expanding the railway, I'm hoping I don't have to write a storyline where the line goes bankrupt. I don't want that. Like, Zeke will find a way out of it, but I just like the idea that he is so... focused on getting the railway, like, you know, longer, he doesn't think about what he actually has already. And when he fails at Barbourne, that
that's gonna give him a reality check, isn't it?
Yeah, it'll give him a reality check and be like, okay, so the railway's like the longest preserved railway in the country now, like in my fictional universe anyway, like being slightly longer than the West Somerset. We've got a good route, we've got a lot of stations, we've got dedicated fans of the railway, blah, blah, blah.
Yeah, like the DRPS.
Hmm.
Excuse me for one moment, I just need to go for a slosh.
No.
Before you get the Hitchin Abbas. Anyways, bear with.
Well, we're not... Oh, okay, well, Anthony's
going to have to entertain then. Oh, no, no, that's my seat. Never mind.
So, Anthony.
Yo.
Your opinions on the line so far, then?
It's the train track.
Thanks.
You had never asked me to give thoughts on something. I will never give you a straight answer.
Well, it looks all right, doesn't it? It looks more realistic this end, I reckon.
Yeah, like, I'd say it does look pretty nitty overall.
I reckon that I still think this section from Bramley Parkway to Barbourne is the better section of the line. It's more scenic. There's more going on. And even though most of it is flat... Oh, the cough was me, by the way. Like, you know, like there's more bridges on this section. There's more embankments on this section. Like, for example, we're going over the bridge now. And down the 1 in 45. So it's time to put the handbrake on. But like I say, I find this section a lot more rugged and more interesting than the main DR. That's why I spend more time on this section.
What would happen if the DR became like a major railroad that connected to London?
Well, it won't because it's not a railroad. It's a railway. But it won't.
We have technically run trains to London from there before.
Yeah, well, we technically still do, like on rail tours anyway. But, because like all this stuff we're doing at the moment, it's making me even think that maybe the line to Horton would become not part of the DR. Maybe it would literally just be like a setting slash red herring sort of thing that like BR trains just end up going to Coalhapa and Coalhapa ends up still being a National Rail Network station. Because that would also mean that I can delete Horton because I don't really like it that much.
Aww.
I mean, I might run up there after I've done, like, when I go back up again, because my whole idea is to go back up the line again, I might run into Horton, but I don't really like it. I think it's just because, I mean, I like it, but I don't see it being part of the actual DR. Does that make sense? Like, I could keep it, but not be part of the DR. Because it doesn't have to be, does it? Gav has a point. Better chance of going to Brighton than London. Although, from Horton, it does head up towards Canterbury, so that's quite an important town. Oh my god, I honestly looked up and thought it said there was three people watching.
Huh.
I thought Chris said he was just going for a whiz.
Whee!
It's a lovely day to walk down the road, and if I ever stop singing, I will explode. Hey, Stephen, what have you done? Boom!
Pretty much. So here we are at Manning's Heath Country Park. It's a station. And as you can see, we've got another sign, Manning's Heath Signal Box. Actually, I don't mind this section. I don't mind this station either. Great conversation.
Hey!
I'm just getting some food, be right back!
Said Chris as he died. So for anyone interested, the reason it's called Manning's Heath Country Park is just over that hill over there is the actual country park. So the DR skirts around the edge of the heath.
Hmm?
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 What?
Hmm? What?
What?
What? Right, let's just check the points. We should be good towards Hitchin Abbas. Well, I'll have to change the points at Hitchin Abbas. Oh. Yeah, I think I've set this correctly. Anyway, let's go. If anyone's wondering, that banker siding is there because when the DR first tried to run a train here, they realised that the 1 in 45 gradient on that bank we just came down is ridiculous. Which it is. It's a redonkulous ingredient. Like 1 in 45 going that way and then a 1 in 101 going up the other way. I mean, that's a cheeky reference already, but... I mean, Anthony gets it, I think, and Chris gets it.
What's this?
The fact that the gradients up to Bramley Parkway are 1 in 45 going one direction and up the tunnel it's 1 in 101.
Yeet.
Cheeky. So yeah, there's Manning's Heath over there. Because like, basically you've got the Heathland on that side and then you've got like forest and stuff on this side and there's a farm as well or some shit up here. I didn't build part of this section. Well, I did, but didn't. Like, I had someone else build part of it for me, like some of the scenery, but I've modified it so much now that it doesn't really matter too much, I don't think. It's a shame, really. I'm kind of hoping it was going to get properly dark at this point in the game, but it hasn't yet. Yes, railway production, you got it right.
This is where Brian's going to be for half the series. Oh yeah, we forgot to mention, from this next series onwards, half the series isn't going to be set on the DR anymore.
Yeah. The other half going to be set on the Bath Temple Coombe line, starring the Founder 4Fs.
No, it's actually going to star the Stubble Valley Railway.
I thought it was starring the BR Standard 2 that's painted in keeping with Valley Red.
I thought you were going to start telling him, shut up, otherwise you're going to get, like, literally a fork shoved up your ass.
I thought you were going to shank me up, then.
Hello there, I'm Mr. B.
Oh god, not this guy again.
Spock, did you guys actually hear me from downstairs?
Sort of.
Sweet.
What?
Fuck you,
Anthony.
What?
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 What? Have you ever wondered?
Watch.
Don't worry, Chris, you haven't got to hitch an abyss yet.
I know, that's why I hurried. I was going up to like, fuck.
To be fair, I think hitch, Manning's Heath actually looks slightly better than hitch an abyss.
I mean, it does.
I still like hitch an abyss because it's named after the, I think I've told you before what it's named after, haven't I?
No.
Hitch and Abbas is named after Itch and Abbas, which was it's the only station on the Mid-Hand Railway between Alton and Winchester that was closed.
Oh.
Like, it hasn't survived. So this is named... Hitch and Abbas is named in honour of Itch and Abbas.
Isn't there something here called the River Hitchin?
Yeah, the River Hitchin is further up.
Sweet.
Although we passed it a minute ago. Like, we passed a bit of the river.
With the farm.
Yeah, well, actually, that might be a different river. I'm not sure yet.
I just really like that, the River Hitchin.
It's hitching up.
Oh, fuck's sake, though. And look, more staggered platform. Well, staggered-ish.
This station is... Yeah, this one has a slightly staggered platform. What I like the most about Hitchin Abbas, though, is those signals up there.
Oh, it looks so good. It looks like they're built into the bridge.
That's the point. That's what I like about them.
I mean, unless someone's sabotaging them, then you're kind of fucked. I have another taco. This is good.
You got tacos again. At least the sun looks like it's starting to set. I'm hoping the lights will start coming on soon.
Sweet.
Well, for some reason, the cab lights in here seem to already be on.
Can I just point something out?
Yeah.
I like how people were asking me if they could come on Discord. And as soon as I give them opportunity, I have zero messages.
I know, it's bizarre, isn't it?
Yeah, so just in case anyone missed it, if you look in the stream chat, if you want to get on the Discord server and you're actually serious about it and you're not a squeaker and you're not under the age of 14, that's where you can add me and then message me. Wait, you can't read my name for? Oh, fuck.
Right, here we go, everyone. This is the section I'm most proud of. What I'll do is I'm staying the cab up, and then once we've run around at Barbel North, I'll get some screenies and stuff on the way back through.
Yeah. Yeah, good one, Gareth. No, but if you can't get my name to work, go on to... Oh, there it goes. Pending. See there? That worked.
So I'm not quite sure why I made this section look so overgrown at the moment, but it looked nice. It'll probably end up looking like this at some point anyway, because this section, I envision that the line to Barbourne North won't really be run as often as such. Like, it won't be like the full terminus of the line will probably be Hitchin Abbas, because it's obviously got the two platforms. Because Barbourne North currently only has one. But again, all of this is liable to change, but it depends what you guys think of it.
I like it.
Here we go, look at this. The River Hitchin actually looks like a river now. And it's blue and lovely and splendid. Literally my favourite section of the line, this is.
Looking good, Tom. I like the fact that you've thrown some reeds in there.
Yeah. But look at the river, look how beautiful it looks.
Yeah, it does. I like the blue, it looks like crystal blue.
Exactly. It's absolutely splendid. And the fact is that the embankment now has two extra bridges on it. Like, because there's a reedy bit down there, as you can see. Absolutely splendid.
And by the by,
mm-hmm.
As soon as I swallow this piece of taco.
Yeah.
Just want to say to Matt and Terry, you said you couldn't get your computer to handle Discord. Well,
you have Discord is online as well.
That too, but like Discord is more friendly than
Skype.
Yeah, Skype or TeamViewer. No, not TeamViewer. Is that TeamViewer?
That's the wrong
thing. What am I thinking of now?
TeamSpeak.
TeamSpeak, that's the one. Yeah.
By the way, there's another Reedy section over here, which is nice. I think people saw them working on it the other day. Is this a what?
Is this Pogo's old railway?
No. Anyway, look at that. Swamp. Oh yeah, we've decided there's got to be a joke when Barry ends up in there and someone got to come past and go, "What are you doing in my swamp?"
Fucking funny.
I love that. That is lovely. Just makes it look and feel a bit more like wetlands out here, like marshland and whatever.
But I think that's us closing in on the final destination, is it not?
Yeah, but we're going to run round the train and go back again.
Oh, sweet.
Oh, I just farted again.
I could tell.
Oh, look, my penchant for gantries is back. Look.
Gantries! Also, let's see.
Someone's asking if you can turn on Pogo Steam music.
Not yet. Maybe later.
Not yet. Maybe later.
But here we are, Barbourne on the single box.
Ah. That makes more sense, Matt.
What?
Well, do you have a... Well, he says his laptop's over 10 years old, so that would make sense on why he can't run Discord. He's having trouble with Firefox.
Oh.
Well, if you have a smartphone, you should be able to, but then your microphone quality will be a bit down.
Right, sorry, Chris, I'm just going to talk over you for a sec, because...
Go for it.
We're at Barbourne North, where we've got, like, that bay platform there will eventually hold two dining coaching, but... Yeah, I've been sorting out the lights and stuff around here, and there's also a bit of extra scenery over there, like there's a little bus depot. Because I have an idea that this would be used as like somebody, like, you know, part of the land over there is owned by a bus company who run buses out this way to connect to the town centre. So, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
So that is... the first section, anyway. I bet you that we're going to run back up the other way and have literally zero problems.
Have what?
Zero problems.
Yeah.
Suddenly, Tom derails on the run-round points.
Oh, fuck off.
Yeah. I predicted the Axie thing, so...
Well... Tom?
Chris?
People are actually saying, you know... that they'd pay for this route, like, 40 quid and stuff.
Well, guess what? That ain't happening.
Good.
I haven't left enough room on the run round. It's only a 6-coach train. Yeah, we've got enough room.
Oi, flip phones don't suck. Do you guys remember having flip phones?
Yeah.
I remember. It was so funny to just go, I need to make a call.
And I'm just going to point out what I'm on about, I think I mentioned in the stream the other night, but this is the reason why we can't go any further than this. Trees in the way, and there's, you know, part of the town of Barbourne in the way on the old track bed. So.
How's that?
That's the building being under construction.
Oh.
Oh. So if I leave that the way it is, it's going to be a shame, but I kind of find it more quaint that this is like a branch line. Because then technically what it's like is you'd have the bigger engines running the line between Kohapa and Merecombe, and then you've got the smaller engines that run... Kohapa to Barbourne. So I did mention earlier that I've got a chest infection, so sorry.
Tom?
What?
Go on the map again.
Yeah.
Go what? A little bit up.
Yeah.
Oh, you removed the triangle. You just added a point that goes up to the left.
What triangle? What? Halted.
At the Clapper Tunnel.
Yeah, there is no longer a triangle there.
Ah, okay. But
removed by BR, remember?
Oh, yeah, shit. Right. Retard. Me. Anyways. But, no, like, I like the secludedness. Like, it reminds me of where I live,
yeah.
Basically.
Well, that's kind of what I like about, like, the path. If I leave it like this, I don't know whether you guys in the audience as well think it's a good idea to leave it how it is, because I like how, as you say, Chris, how quaint it is, how, like, even though it's near a town, it's on the very outskirts of a town for a change, rather than being in the centre of a town like most of my stations are.
Yeah, it's more calm and peaceful and, you know, nothing big happening. While in the city, you'd have buses, cars, people, work, you know, all that stuff. While here, it's just a bit more quiet, you know?
I mean, like, if someone wanted to travel from Merecombe to Barbourne, they can get one of these trains, then all they'd have to do is get a short, like, even a short walk into the town, because the town's not that far. You could probably walk it.
Yeah. Also, I'm sorry if you guys can hear snoring, but one of my dogs is, like, snoring louder than people that live in this house.
Oh. But yeah, you've also got, like I say, like, you got that, because obviously what you've got to remember is that this station is, and this station, and, oh shit, I never changed the point, did I? This station and Manning's Heath never existed under BR rule. Like, the only station on this section was Bramley Parkway and Hitchin Atlas.
Ah.
But as you can see by the proximity as well to the railway line that's down there, there isn't that much of a gap between the Barbourne Dock Railway and this line.
That's why I like it. It's Barbourne North. It's like, you know.
Well, it's north of the city.
Yeah, exactly. And also really glad that for once you took the numbers in the middle seriously instead of writing, you know, fuck or ass or...
I'm sorry to disappoint you, Chris.
Or supercalifragilisticexpialidocious. You know, something like that. How would you even fit that in there?
I don't know.
You'd probably figure out a way.
Probably. Anyway, time to go back up again. In fairness, I'm actually thinking what I might do and go up to Coalhapper, over to Horton, back to Coalhapper and down to Barbourne again, because I'm not tired or anything yet, so, and there's lots of people watching, so, yeah.
Man, we're almost up to 40 people watching. That's not bad.
Yeah, it isn't bad. And the problem is, I can't work out why these signals never change the way you want them to. Because they never sort of want to, for some reason.
Why are you red?
What's that blue light, by the way? I've been thinking about that.
AWS.
Ah, that's the one. What a cunt. If you guys have seen any of my stuff, you know that I hate AWS.
Now, the station is called Barbourne North, but we've only got the enamel for Barbourne. Because I think, as this is like, you know, a heritage line, Barbourne main station would be like Barbourne Central or whatever, and it'd probably have its own, oh crap, oh god, the passenger doors are open. Oh well. We'll try and get them closed again at Hitchin Atlas. People just have to have a nice, lovely breeze on the way down.
Fucking hell, that must be terrifying.
Oh, I didn't even think about that. But yeah, I love the idea that this is like a branch line. But I reckon the big engines would come down here from time to time, like even the Bully Pacifics and whatnot. But especially because of the gradients and stuff. But it does look quite funny, doesn't it? So I can't take any screenshots now.
Fuck's sake.
But I can. From this side. Yeah. Look at the oh god, that's beautiful. Look at that.
Oh my god, that colour.
And the sun reflecting off it as well.
And the flowing. Oh. How could you, Tom? Also, I did not turn into a goat. Fuck off.
Well, you did.
Oh, that's in. Oh. Oh, God.
Where's our train? Oh, very slowly coming. Cheeky.
Someone in my guild is named Mike Hunt.
Oh.
That's an old joke.
I hope I'm getting a nice, I'm probably getting a nice screenshot from here.
Heard you.
I just saw the sun jump.
Did it?
Yeah.
That's when I'll jump.
He must have been scared.
Go ahead and jump. A little bit of Van Halen here.
Problem with this is because I was on that temporary route and I really wanted to make something similar to that, so that's why we've got this section.
Well, you did a good job.
I hope so.
Oh! Fucking all those yellow flowers!
What?
We have those outside my house.
Oh, what, daffodils?
That's the one, daffodils. Oh, I love... Have you ever had that prank where you, like, you get someone to smell the flower and you pop off the top into their face?
No.
Man, you guys did not have a childhood.
Damn, what's
we
that?
Used those things in guns.
What was it, Chris?
You know daffodils? Like, they have this thing where you can, like,
flick your thumb at the
flower.
They have a bell top,
basically, is what you're saying.
Yeah, they have a bell top, and they can pop off if you just flick your thumb at it hard enough. We used to go in the forest, pick a bunch of daffodils, and then just use that as guns and shoot at each other with them. Like, it's completely harmless. It's just for fun.
Now, the problem with the river here is that it's ruined my... You know, this is where I normally take my screenshots for Dark Tries, everyone.
Well, just stand there.
Yeah, I know. But it's sort of changed it forever, hasn't it? But it looks gorgeous.
It does.
Who gave you the right to be good at root building?
Years of practice, I guess.
Also teach me, senpai, please.
No.
What? Oh. Can't you just build me a root like Andy did, only smaller?
Maybe. Look at that. And even looking in this direction's not bad either. Or even better.
Oh, look
guys, look at this. Oh my good yarn.
Oh my god.
See what that I mean? Do you see what I mean about this section being my favorite section on the line now, everyone?
Yeah. Oh, look at the reflection.
That's what I'm trying to get a screenshot of. Hold on.
Oh, the reflection.
There we go.
Also, is it just me or the coach door still? Oh, wait.
Yeah, they're still open, but I don't mind. I'll get a better screenshot at some point.
You need to take screenshots of 257 here, like Matt is saying.
I know. I will do.
This is where they could take their profile pictures, you know?
Yeah, maybe.
Not like for Facebook or anything, but like, you know.
But yeah, I definitely think that this section here is probably the best section on the whole line, and it's quite fitting that it's right at the end.
I mean,
like, if the railway's going to try and get to somewhere, like, you know, somewhere important and they can't make it, well, at least make up for it for having some damn lovely scenery.
Yeah.
So, like, you know, I can see this being a new section of the line where photographers, like, try and get down to the riverside and, like, it'll be better than Wall Church Viaduct.
Yeah. Wall Church Viaduct. Whee! And then this one.
But those, the blueness of the lake, I really need to sort that out and have the same at Wall Church and maybe get some reeds in the lake at Wall Church as well. Because clearly that looks good.
It does. Tom, I want more. Make more.
No.
Oh. Why?
Because I said.
It's because of isms again.
Might be. Oh. What I'm going to do is when we get to Hitchin Abbas, I'm going to check the points and set the train rolling up and hope... I mean, I might miss Manning's Heath, but as long as I've got... as long as I get back before the incline, otherwise my train's going to sort of just stop.
True.
Yes, Railway Productions, that's not a bad idea either. Having, like, problems where trespassers, basically. Like, you know, the railway has the private land over the river, but obviously each side of the river is owned by other peeps. You know, like, although I think that the DR owns the land, but, like, some of it anyway, but maybe there still is issues. There is a reason why I want to run up and down this section, by the way, everyone. And that's because I'm waiting for it to get dark in the game.
Mr. Dark.
And I'm probably going to keep running until it gets dark. So it might well be shuttle trains between... I'm probably not going to go as far as Merecombe now, but I'm probably going to go Barbourne, Colhapper, Horton, Colhapper, Barbourne, until it gets dark. I love the way the signal box now has the name on it. So you know at all times what signal box you are at. And plus, Hitchin Abbas! Woo!
Woo!
I'm trying to find a station sign to look at. Well, oh well, never mind. So what we're going to do is we're going to try and get the passengers sorted out so they close the door. I mean, we'd say Hitchin Abbas is probably, like, maybe... Well, maybe second or third... Well, I think this is the best looking of the towns, maybe. Because you can see the town of Hitchin Abbas over there. You've got these nice clear fields here. Oh, that looks nice with the sun. But, yeah, I don't know. I don't like the station building, though, because it's an old default one. But I suppose I've customized it enough for it to not matter that much.
Yeah, it's better than mine. Then again, I started rebuilding like 5 days ago.
Oh yeah, and then I got the, well, it's not really an abbey, but at least you've got a graveyard over here. This is details you're probably never going to really see in the series. Like, I imagine that this would only be seen when, like, a character, like a human character dies, maybe.
Yeah.
Like, as the place they're later left to Hitch and Abbas. Because that looks good. Anywho, yep, the doors have closed, so we're going to have a nice jaunty slow run. I'm going to head down for a cigarette.
Oh no, does that mean we have to entertain?
Yes. Anthony's a shit entertainer, so Chris, please help me out.
Tom, may I show them the route Andy built for me?
I don't know, how are you going to do that? Because I'm dreaming.
Give him the video?
No.
Oh. Well, people have been Shrek'd.
Oh yeah, I'm going to put a little bit of quiet music underneath. So, as somebody requested earlier, I'm going to play Pogo Miranaki.
Ah, yes. Time for some moaning.
Only quietly, though, because I'm hoping you two will entertain. Meanwhile, I'll just get the train so it's going.
Probably, we'll just probably get told to shut the fuck up. because of music. How can you not like this song? It's so good.
Right, BRB, everyone.
No. Just goodbye.
So, what do we do now?
What do we do when we need a what?
What you gonna do with the baby? So Anthony, how goes the follow for us?
First of all, no they're not. Stop trying to hijack my property, bitch.
That?
It's a train. Woo! And they're four Fs, and they pull traps, and then dicks.
They're coming to town, not Tom. You fucking banana.
Oh no, I can't be a banana. Chris will have it.
For shit entertainers.
No, I'm not being a chicken fly. Like, go away.
Oh, by the way, wouldn't it be funny if this farm that we're passing right now has chickens on it, but the one Barry's trying to get to doesn't?
Hmm?
You know the farm we just passed?
What farm?
The one that's on the side of the river.
You see it?
Okay, you're stupid. There's a farm there. Wouldn't it be funny if that was the one that had chickens?
There you go. Suddenly Barry went for a swim.
For fuck's sake, Barry. It's like you want to die. Oh, my screen just went off. Yeah.
Screen went yellow.
Yeah.
Well, bye, Chris's computer. Oh.
No, Anthony, it's the blue light filter thing. It's so that my eyes are like, they can't go.
Boy, right there, Ted.
English? Don't worry, Tom, I'll stop 40. Oh, wait.
Sorry, guys, can't stop, no brakes.
No driver.
No driver.
I'm driving with a fag in the other coach. Well, to be fair, this only means that Tom gets a run up on the hill. I mean, is this really a 145?
I guess so.
Because Andy's climbing it like it's a 1 in, you know, 300,000.
No, Horton's were out in the thing. And yes, awesome, we've all seen G1.
Actually, I've seen G2 already.
Well, I saw Beast Wars, so therefore I win.
Shit.
Even though that's technically a lie, I've never actually watched Beast Wars.
And I can't believe it, we made it up the hill without me having to do anything.
Oh, fuck me sideways.
Anyway, we're back.
I'm impressed, Tom. You actually did good. You didn't crash.
Yay.
Yee. Now, how do I sharpen a pencil?
You don't. You know what? I've got a nasty feeling it's not going to get dark anytime soon.
Why not?
Because the time in game is nearly 8 o'clock in the evening in the summer. And the sun doesn't usually go down to like 9:30 in game, does it? We'll see, I'm gonna run as long as it takes.
Are you just gonna drive your train for as long as it takes to get dark?
Well, as long as people are entertained, then yeah.
Well, if you guys wanna see something else, just shout at us like, Tom!
I mean, I could go to the editor and just change up to be a dark run.
Hey, I see what you did there.
But I'd have to change the loco to have one with a high intensity headlamp, so it'd be a Raymond probably. So yeah, I'm hoping everyone likes see a look of the route now, like this section anyway. And actually, to be fair, the rest of the route doesn't look too bad either anymore. But I don't know.
Hang on, which side is the branch line on again?
What, the branch?
Was the branch?
The branch was on that side, over there.
Alright.
That's why they got the fence there, and then you got the old platform face there still.
So now Anthony's going to steal your idea and make the Bramley engines.
Oh, yeah, if you're stealing it for us, I'm making the Bramley engines.
Even though, like, while we're sat here, I'm going to follow the old track bed just so you guys know where it goes. Because I did build this route and then I took it down again, but
yeah, I remember actually that was quite nice. Why'd you tear it down again?
Because I was debating whether it was going to be a narrow gauge or not, and I couldn't
remember.
So the line would go over here, and then there was going to be a little platform here called Brampton Heath, hence why the road just stops there. Oh, I never got my cough sweet, and then it was going to run down under this bridge, and then along where the path, basically this path would have run parallel to the narrow gauge line or the standard gauge or whatever. That's why the fence is still there. and it runs to the town of Bramley here. And as you can see, the old goods shed is still there, but there's no station here at present. But there was a station just here, in this, like, this bit here. So, I still could do it.
I guess.
But again, there's not really that machinery around this bit, but it doesn't need to be. But yeah, this would have been the town of Bramley. Oh, I did actually put some effort into it, I guess. But as you can see, like, it is literally a drive away to the DR station over here. And if you're wondering, the road to the town goes this way, and then it goes under there, and it's supposed to go into the town there. But as you can tell, I didn't do too much faraway scenery. So yeah, I suppose we better go, ain't we? So it looks like down here on the embankment, like my first attempt at making an embankment proper. Might make a nice little screenshot here as well, actually. Guys.
Andy, smile for the camera. Honk.
Andy, flip them off.
So yeah, I definitely think there's a lot more visual interest on this section of the route anyway. Like, the ground elevation, I mean. Like, the fact there's embankments, bridges, all that jazz.
Well, the thing is, and I've always said this, but it looks good, but there's always room for improvement, isn't there?
Hmm.
And I'm just thinking, like, because what you have now, that runs semi-okay with the 32-bit version.
It imagine when you run have better with 64-bit.
Yeah, 64-bit. You can throw down a lot of more stuff and experiment a lot more, you know?
Fingers crossed.
Yeah. That's loud.
That's loud. Another interesting nugget fact. I was considering the line from, like, a bypass line anyway. You'll probably be able to see where it could have been, but which would have bypassed Kohapa Tunnel and gone overland towards Horton, joining up on the Horton line, like a bigger triangle. But you'll see it in a minute, because if you see, there's a bridge coming up, isn't there?
I can
see. And yes, sir. And yes, I have noticed that fence is up. I will fix that at a later point.
Fuck, I was gonna say it.
But you see, the bridge has three openings. Well, four.
I do.
No, three. That third opening on the right hand side, that would have been where the railway line diverged and went underneath that bridge. And it would have diverged over that way. Like, the trees obviously cover it now, but I think if I just ate a sec, you should be able to see that there's you can see the embankment and track bed that would have gone to Horton this way.
Ah.
So, just like as an avoiding line. But then the problem with that is it would have meant that going to Kohapa was pointless.
Hmm.
I'm going to zoom through the tunnel because everyone gets bored of sitting in tunnels.
Once an engine attached to a train.
Oh, shut up.
said Andy, as he ran into the tunnel and wouldn't come out.
You see, there's an interesting plot point I've got idea-wise, which would be that Dave starts to get a subconscious fear of tunnels because of what, like, in the version that didn't happen, where you know where you got crushed in the tunnel in Time Waits for No One Part 1?
Yeah.
Well, that would, like, even though that technically didn't happen, I reckon he'd have nightmares about that sort of thing happening, or even experiencing a nightmare where that happens properly, like in TSX mode, obviously. But what happens to Dave is that when the extension from Coalhapen to Bramley Parkway opens up, and he comes along the line, and he discovers there's a tunnel, kind of the opposite of Henry, but he sees the tunnel and he stops. Like, even though he's gone through the tunnel at Gasworks many times, you got to remember, these nightmares only start afterwards, after the tunnel collapses. And I think it's that fear of dying in a tunnel, or seeing, even maybe just seeing Leanne die in the tunnel, that causes him to be scared of going into the tunnel. And maybe he, like, no matter what they try, Dave will refuse to go into the tunnel, and they basically just can't force him to go into the tunnel if he doesn't want to. And eventually, I think he will conquer his fear of tunnels again, after he sees that the engine go through it, like, no problem after this point. Make sense?
Yeah.
Didn't he meet tunnel?
Great Western 8, I'm probably guessing we're not going to see this extension until, like, season 11 or something like that.
Yeah, it's not going to be for a long time yet. I'm not expecting, like, we're in the year 1973. I'm not expecting the line to get to Bramley Parkway until about maybe 77 or 78. Maybe even earlier, like 75 maybe. But definitely going to Hitch and Abbas will take until at least the late 80s. So yeah, sorry if people get disappointed at that.
Lol.
But I'm trying to be realistic in timescale. I don't want to just suddenly be like, oh, we can buy this railway line. Oh, really? Yes, it's going to be restored in 5 minutes. If that, again, makes any sort of sense.
Yep.
This is where the station at Coalhapen West was going to be.
Ah.
Like, this supermarket was where it was. But I kind of wondered whether it would be, you know... whether there's any point having a station there. But then again, when you see the distance between Coalhapen Main Station and Coalhapen West, maybe it does kind of make sense that there could be a platform there one day. I don't know. I don't know. What do you think, Anthony Banderas?
I think we should blow up a bridge.
So we're not going to jump off a bridge?
What a stupid idea, Gareth.
Why are you blaming Gareth?
I always find a convenient scapegoat.
I'm not your scapegoat. Ram it down your damn throat.
Mr. Gareth, are you responsible for the events that happens on the Dark Railway?
Well, let me tell you. I am not. I am totally to blame for what happened on the Dark Railway, and I do it again tomorrow.
Well, let me tell you, Sonny Jim, my name is Bob.
I'm not tired yet, 10 seconds later.
Yeah, 10 minutes later. So here we are, back at Coalhapen. Gareth blaming it, saying that he didn't cause the gasworks collapse by sitting on the side of the embankment. I reckon he did.
Everyone knows that was Brian.
Oh yeah, that was Brian, wasn't it? So what I think I might do is change it up a bit. And I might load a new scenario in it called Happer and change engine and change to a nighttime. If people go for it.
That's actually the big plot twist of a later series, by the way. It turns out that the gasworks tunnel collapsed, it wasn't actually because Leanne derailed in the tunnel. It was because Brian was sat on the embankment. He never actually went off to the Bluebell.
Wow. Fuck's off. So we're going to stop here. I'm going to put up my loading screen. Once we exit and build a new scenario. And as it's quiet, what should I put on?
Crawling in my skin! You said it was quiet.
Only because your name's Chris.
Well, my name is not Chris, as a matter of fact.
In a matter of fact, it's actually Jim.
You can expect no new characters in TDR season
9.
No,
you can. There's going to be one new character, Chris, remember?
I'm aware there's going to be one new character.
I mean, Barry knows all about him.
Yeah, me too.
Indeed he goes.
I know who you're talking about. I was trying to make a joke.
You will be a fine addition to my lovely family.
I thought you were going to say collection. I was going to say General Grievous. You're shorter than I expected.
Execute order 66.
It's not the beaching axe.
No, it's the beaching quacks.
Oh, fuck.
Will there be another Barry? What?
There can be only one.
Yup, there's only one Barry.
My boyfriend said I'm the most beautiful girl in the world. Mine did too. Shink, there can only be one.
Oh no! Giant flying sheep!
Those are clouds. No!
I mean, if you want to go full G1. Lads, look in the mirror, lads. I love having a mirror next to me. Wait, hang on. So if I looked in the... Like, if I was in that universe and I looked into glass and it had a slight reflection, would that freeze me?
Well, no. Did you ask it?
Even, like, polished tiles. Like, holy shit. That's dangerous, you know?
Actually, you know what? I'm going to change my mind on what I'm going to drive. Because I just thought, if I can get it to be a dark scenario, I just thought of the perfect engine I can drive. And it's steam.
Oh, is it Supercross 47?
No, it's your dad.
Oh.
Anyway, whilst you're all bapping around getting your next chuff-chuff in order, I'm going to nip out for a moment.
Alright.
Bye then.
I'm only going to be like a minute.
It's not good enough?
Yeah, okay, that's a minute too much, Anthony. But anyways, take care of yourself.
Yeah, bitch. Well, it's still not technically dark enough, so... Oh jeez, Rick. Ah, here we go, this is better.
Thank you.
No one's gonna be able to guess what I'm driving.
A train.
Maybe.
Heh. What do I win?
A banana boat. Boom! What do we have here, Chris?
Oh shit! It's Leander!
It's not Leander, you fucking prick.
It's George Stevenson.
It's Georgie boy.
That Valgear, though.
Oh, I love the Stevenson Valgear. It's so annoying.
Why is it annoying?
Because I like
Dave,
it so much.
Dave, you're getting rebuilt.
I can't do it. The nameplates aren't... No, it's so annoying. The nameplates aren't removable.
Yeah.
And anyway, it wouldn't be authentic for Dave because it's got a forward top three boiler.
Oh.
The only reason I picked up George anyway is because he's got the high intensity headlamp as well.
Oh.
And of course, everyone knows how much I love Black 5, so.
So why are you driving a Black 6? This is technically a Black 6 because of the value, because it's an upgrade.
Well, no, it's not. It's still the same power class, you dolt.
Oh.
So we've got Hold George on. Visiting the DR for no reason whatsoever.
Oh, hello there. Get out of here, George.
Why, hello there. My name is George. Why do you sound like such a prick? Aren't you named after a really famous engineer? No. I like to eat cake. Oh.
Can I eat cake?
No.
No.
Anyway, for anybody who's like didn't watch my dark tries, there's a really good reason why this particular Black 5 is so unique, and that's its valve gear. As you'll see when we're on the move, it hasn't got conventional wall sharks gear. What it has got is a banana boat, though.
Of course you've picked George Stevenson.
Yep, of course I have. Well, we're running in the dark, Anthony. I've got to drive something I enjoy, and it's got high-intensity headlamps, so that helps as well. Oh, I'm going to show the valve gear off for a minute. Sort of. I hope people realise that it's only the same type of valve gear that is on the inside of certain steam engines. It's just mounted on the outside.
Why is it mounted on the outside?
Easier to maintain.
Why is it easier to maintain?
Oh, Chris, shut up.
Oh, you busted me with trying to get the book started.
Oh, someone might have recognised as well, I don't know if Chris recognises it, but you know the intro sound I use now for my videos, what I've started using from today?
Yeah.
It's actually just the exhaust sound from a Black 5.
Did you actually get your transparent thing to work or not?
Yeah, I did, yeah. But I need to actually go and film a proper clip.
Clip me up, Bobby.
Ah. I love engine with high intensity headlamps.
Do you?
Maybe.
Whistle. Tom, are you trying to give me a boner here?
No.
Controls whistle again.
Oh, I farted again.
That's gross. Where are we off to anyway, my good sir?
We're doing what I said I was going to do earlier. Horton, Cole Happer, and then we'll go back to Barbourne and probably finish up there. I will point out the scenery up here isn't as good as the rest of the line. But I did say this was a cab ride, so... I suppose I better check the points of Hawk now.
Suddenly a rogue service came through.
Holy shit!
I thought it was literally just the three of us.
Yeah, I know. I wonder where everyone was, to be quite honest. It's a Friday night. That was literally the reason why I do these on a Friday night, because notoriously, Friday night is normally the night where people are a bit more, you know. Oh, it does look good at speed.
Oh, Jesus. Okay, so now I have one dog beneath the desk snoring, one dog behind me snoring. This is going to be a fun night. Also, why is that train got a whistle?
Because it has.
I thought rail buses were electric, grandfather. Now we've branded it.
They are mostly, but this is a steam rail bus. Thing is, I did actually say it, but because I was clicked on Task Manager, it wouldn't actually, like, let me record.
Oh.
Oh.
Now here's the important question. How long until Chris drops a coach?
No.
You know what we could do, like, after this, Tom, unless you're, you know, tired by then?
Not really, it's only like half nine.
You could do a bit of a Shrekking on the Wrecking Post.
Yeah, I'm up for that. If we do Horton to Cole Happer, and then Cole Happer to Barbourne again at night, and then we'll do some Wreckfest.
Yeah, we can just kill this stream, let that be its own thing, and then start up another one with the peeps if they want.
Yeah, can do.
Oh, there goes my phone calling.
That's how means you've got to go.
BRB.
Suddenly Chris came back fuming. Chris, don't get your lad!
There. Right,
Anyone fancy meeting Chris for a minute while he's on the phone?
Bounty goes.
Oh jeez, this train just is not slowing down, is it?
There.
Evening.
Did I mute myself or did I not?
No, you didn't, so that's why I showed you down there.
Yeah, sorry about that. I thought I muted myself. Apologies, people. That's
have you gone to pick up your dad?
No.
No.
He has some other stuff that's not too fun, but we can say that afterwards.
Man, Horton looks dead, doesn't it?
Yeah, as long as my car's not there.
Actually, I'm not sure. Let's go have a look.
Swear to God, you need to move that thing, Tom.
Nope, it's still there.
Fuck's sake! Tom, get that thing to fucking Kolhapur or something like that.
No. But this is what I mean about Horton being dead, because I haven't done any of the lighting or anything around here yet.
Ah. Power outage at Horton.
Well,
so, running around the Christmas tree, happy holiday.
Basically.
Well, speaking of Christmas, now that there's only, what, 3 months?
It.
No, hang on. I'll finish this. 3 months and 3 days until Christmas. Can we just shut the fuck up about it? It's not even Halloween yet! And as me and Anthony were discussing the other day, I have seen Christmas decorations already.
Fortunately, I have not.
Yeah, like, I'm pretty sure like in 2025 or something like that, they're gonna throw fucking Christmas decoration up the day after Christmas.
Rude.
So, that's a question, Tom. Are we going to go to Horton first or Barbourne first?
We're at Horton, you pleb.
I meant in the series.
Oh, I'm still debating whether we're even going to go to Horton as a main DR platform.
Oh, like you're just going to go straight to Barbourne and then...
Well, yeah, because I might leave it as if being BR operated.
Yeah.
Maybe. I mean, we'll decide later on.
Thank you.
It's only now, after I can't make a difference in any of these people's poor lives, that I've heroically decided to speak. Said Raymond.
Raymond haunts this form. He was very haunted.
Haunt.
What?
Rocking around the coaches, holy shit, George Stevenson slow. Isn't he slower than normal back fives?
In reality, they weren't any faster. George Stevenson wasn't a faster accelerator, but it would noted it was better on banks, but it wasn't any more efficient or anything.
Fair enough. Less sigh. Also, don't crash through the coaches. Sorry, Ted, can't stop, no brakes.
Bang! It's alright, Chris.
Sorry, lad, can't stop, no brakes. Said Pat as he flew through a coach. It is a very nice engine, though.
Hello, so Callum Booth, by the way.
Hello there. So what, they didn't come with the double chimney?
George Stevenson originally had a double chimney, but it was taken off in the 50s.
Huh.
It was like one of the only Black Fives, apart from some of the Cabride ones, to have double chimneys fitted.
Fair enough. Oh, the good shed. Well, the wrecked good shed. Wrecked or erect?
I admit it's a nice quick run back to Cole Harper.
100 miles an hour. You're second valving it?
Yeah.
Sweet.
We're technically on the main line, so I haven't got to stick to any speed limits.
Thrashing! Wait, what?
What?
Trains can just go as fast as they want on the main line.
Well, no, within reason. Like, steam engines are only allowed up to, like, 75 max.
Ah, okay. I was like, what? What kind of a fucking anarchy things are going on out there?
Mere anarchy.
I knew you were going to say that.
Although, technically speaking, as I'm running 10 to first, the max is 45.
George Stevenson is officially the meaning of life.
Fuck's sake. The meaning of life is 42.
Did you guys know that you can fly if you jump from a high enough place?
Yeah.
I mean, you're gonna hit the ground at the end, but...
What?
Well, I wouldn't know, George, you big bollocks.
Fuck Anthony.
I didn't actually know that about George Stevenson. It was actually built with electric lightning.
Yeah.
That was quite unique,
it was taken
it?
Off and then reinstated in press. I bet you didn't know that either.
No.
Nope.
Oh, Anthony.
What?
Don't look at what Crane posted.
Well, I'm a rebel, so I'm gonna do it anyway.
Yeah.
Well, that's a question, Tom.
Mm-hmm.
Out of all the, like, brainstorming thingies that we've done, well, no, actually, that's a different question, because then we don't spoil anything. But, like, to the people in the chat, what are you most looking forward to Season 9? And if you're looking forward to something, what are you hoping to see more of, less of, or hoping will be a thing?
Just be careful what you hope for, because a certain character won't be returning for Season 9.
Yeah, but, yeah, like,
I'm pretty sure some people knew about that.
Yeah. But, yeah, if someone wants to say something, like, go for it. Like, what are you hoping to see? What do you like? What do you hate? More of Turbo. That's the first. Duncan.
Oh.
He's cool. Hope Barry eats. I had nothing to do with that. After this. Wow, we're already here?
Yeah, it's not long from Horton to Cole Harper.
I guess that's right. Just like what? Actually to Walls Church or maybe...
It's about... There? I think it's about... 4 miles or something like that?
More Pogo appearances. They've returned to service. People are actually replying to us. What?
I know, surprising, right?
Yeah.
Although, as we're going to see, Dave is actually going to be turning into a banana boat.
That's a good song.
Go for fuck's sake, Anthony.
What's a good song?
What was it? It's something railway song.
Something called the Carnfall song.
Well then, I have a question for you, Anthony.
Mm-hmm.
Was there a red BR standard 2MT in there?
No, but you can frankly go and shove like a chainsaw up your ass.
Oh, this is quite vroom, vroom.
Ah! Okay, that was interesting.
It was.
Complete brake failure.
Oh, great. Can you fix it?
Yeah, yeah. What I mean is, like, I've accidentally put the brakes on fully. I'm not quite sure how I managed that.
How Dave and Del triple interact. Ooh.
Mmm.
Raymond returned to the future. What do you mean? Raymond is in the present day. What?
What?
I'm confused. People are saying weird stuff. Remember that thing where, you know how you crack a knuckle, right?
Yes.
Ever had that with, like, the joint right above your ankle?
No.
Oh, it's so weird.
Yeah, the thing with Leander is that, like, she's dead now. That's
she's
the end
gone,
of it.
She's dead. That's that one song goes, the bitch is dead.
Which or which?
The bitch, not the witch.
Well, which or which died?
I would say her name, but that's, you know.
Oh.
It's like...
Oh, it was, it was that boy?
Yeah, oh shit, what up? Nah, I was thinking of Margaret Thatcher.
So now my next question is, do I run in the dark up to Barbourne? Or shall me and Chris switch over to Wreckfest?
Like, let's see what the people think.
I'm still down for doing the run. I'm only going to do a quick run up and down, but I wouldn't mind doing some Wreckfest as well. It depends, really, because we've seen the other side of the line, but I would like to see what it looks like in the dark, to be quite honest, because I haven't looked at it in the dark yet.
And that's one Barbourne. Like, it's either Barbourne or Wreckfest. That's what you guys got to reply. And you guys decide next time. Wait, shit, no, that's the wrong show.
Well, that's two for Barbourne.
One for Wreckfest. 24 people. I think it's going to be Barbourne, mate.
That's fine. I want to get running around then.
Yee. Don't worry, Wreckfest is going to happen.
It's like, just how soon.
Yeah, how soon. I may have to throw the dogs out of my room, though, if we're gonna do Wreckfest.
Who threw the dogs out? Chris did!
Where are you gonna throw them out? The window. Don't you live on the third story? Yay! Yeah, we're going to Barbourne, lads. Lads, I looked at the map.
Sirliv, yes.
What?
Sirliv said, will part of the future of the TDI season be acquiring and rebuilding the line to Barbourne North? And that's a yes. I hope I changed those points properly. Yes, I did.
Callum Booth, she can't. He's already tried it. She's failed. She's, like, super dead now.
Yeah.
Is she, like, mecha dead?
She's properly dead, as in, like, you know, she was murderized.
Oh, shit. Wow, you're running around fast. You really want to get going, don't you?
Well, What I'm trying to work out though is how a here we go. Mm-hmm.
Why'd you run around the train so quickly?
Because it did.
Shit.
Problem?
Pollution?
Oh.
The tau cannon. Well, bollocks.
What?
Oh, nothing. I just wanted to say something. So, how are we gonna do the Shrekking then, Tom? Are we gonna do what we usually do?
What's that?
Team up DDJ Drift Team, or just... Well, that really depends on who's in the server, yeah. Doesn't it? Oh yeah, Anthony. Oh great, Barry's there. Well, it's only you and me, Tom.
That was it.
Well, Anthony
we'll make
is...
We'll make a quick run then. We'll make this a quick one. Especially trying to get up as much speed as I can before the tunnel.
Yeah.
Can you, see the fog coming out of the chimney?
I can. It looks nice. It's like some small stars, you know, only, you know, shit tons of them flying out of the chimney.
Yeah.
And there they go.
I love how you can see the sparks, it's lovely.
Well, you're literally just checking out the sparks. You really are a daffodil, aren't you? Wouldn't it have sucked if the points were set for Cole or not Horton?
I would not.
Nah, I said it wouldn't have sucked. Ah well, it's only a bit of fun. And the night running on this game is fun. Speaking of darkness, tunnel 3, 2, 1. Wait, the light just turned off.
It didn't turn off.
Oh, I just can't see 2 feet in front of me. Oh, there we go. You know, whenever the you do that as a driver, I just imagine his neck growing longer and longer.
No. What I'll do, Chris, we'll do a very quick run down to Barbourne.
Yep.
And then we'll stop this stream. I'll go and have a cigarette. And then we'll play some breakfast for a couple of hours.
Good, because then I can set up my stream while you take a cigarette. I'm probably just doing it now and get ready.
Didn't hear a word you just said because you're in a tunnel.
I said I'll just set the shit up while you're in the tunnel!
Okay!
You've got it set as your default video on your channel.
This is my favorite video.
Eh? Tom, are you do a background core tears? In the dark railway? Background characters.
I have no idea what you're talking about.
Does Eddie count?
Yeah, I forgot about that. There's a little light here.
Remind me, on the Bossman Black 5, does it come with a controls to operate the injectors, or...?
No, not really.
Aww.
The reason, though, you just do... It's actually easier than most other engines, just tap, like, L and then O. And then...
Like, tap L and O.
Yeah, and then, like, tap K and I, and that turns on the injectors.
What, you mean I just do a quick, like...
Yeah.
And then that...
And that's
on,
it,
not
it's
like...
on. Yeah. Not having to hold it open or anything, no.
See, Anthony, even I was retarded to do that.
Yeah, but you forget, I'm part of a very special camp.
Same.
Okay, so Bradley Parker looks not bad at night.
Ooh.
Not bad at all.
That's you.
Okay. Oh, I just got a super chat.
Oh, that's a... Wow.
What? Thank you very much. Donk Splongler.
And Batman from the 60s.
Some days you can't just can't get over there. Let me restart that again. Some days you just can't get rid of a bomb.
Oh, balls, we're on the bloody downhill bit, aren't we?
What?
I said, oh, balls, we're on the downhill bit.
Oh, balls!
Oh, balls! Question is, are we going to manage to stop at Hetch and Manning's Heath, I wonder?
Question. But do you need an answer?
Bleh. Oh, excuse me.
Sometimes you just can't speak English, said Anthony.
Yeah.
Sometimes you have to go with the flow and speak New Jerseyan.
Now I shall have to go away.
That's like only the third time ever somebody's used Super Chat.
Yeah. Oh, I'm sorry, guys, but should I mention all the languages I can speak and just shut everyone up and chat?
Oh, shut up.
Norwegian, Swedish, Danish, English, Spanish.
Danish isn't German. A real language.
I know, it's just a potato that you've thrown. Russian. And some Scottish.
Oh yeah, look at that.
I can't. It's oh wait, my screen is paused. The blower was on. Cheeky.
I mean, look at the nice look at the atmosphere at this particular station. It's nice, isn't it?
It is.
Like, look at this dude here. He's like, oh shit, what up? And this dude over here is like,
where's my money, bitch?
He's just looking at the wall, just like, one day, this wall will do me a big, big favor. Anyway.
Anyway.
Oh. There you go. Just press O and then L, and that turned the ejectors off.
Cheeky.
So you lot moan about the Black 5 being advanced. It's actually really easy. So this is, what, Manning's Heath? So next up, Hitch and Abbas.
Most likely.
Well, not like we can go anywhere else.
Could go to, you know, Norway.
Well, yeah, there's that, I guess. Actually, if I might make a different shot in a sec, hold on. What the hell's wrong with the tender? Anyone else notice that?
What?
As we went past, the tender was like a darker black.
Oh. Racist.
In it.
Shit.
Suddenly Barry came behind him. What are you doing in me swamp? Wait, shit, I just remembered I speak Irish too. Pug Mahon.
Punk. It's a bit spooky out here like this, doesn't it?
Oh, I imagine this in dense fog, mate. With a bit of a Near Anarchy look to it. That that cab lighting, though.
I know, right?
So, what's next?
Hitch and Abbas.
And then Barbourne North.
And then Barbourne North.
Breakfast!
Oops, there goes a bottle of gin. Why would you name me like this?
Dad, I'm hungry!
Hi, hungry, I'm Dad.
Name me like this? Are your wheels locked up, Tom?
Mm-hmm.
Are your wheels locked up?
No.
They're sparking.
It's the brake blocks.
Ah. Oh, that's different reason. You gonna stop in time? Oh yeah, you're good.
The mighty Hitch and Abbas at night. Mmm.
Suddenly Tom crashed. George!
You didn't even remember that much, to be fair.
I mean, if I was dispatched on this route, I'd tell you to go back half a mile and try again, but you
fuck
know.
Off. I mean, I can imagine, like, I don't know how to put this, but I can imagine, like, on a late night service like this in the winter or something, like, Hitch and Abbas would be the last station on the line going back to Kolhapa.
Yeah, because of the whole connection with the town.
Yeah,
right?
Well, I mean, like, there could be a... Like, the last train could go there, but, like, what I mean is the final terminating station on... Well, actually, no, I don't know. Ow. Ow.
You alright?
It's right, my, you know, area.
Yeah.
Ooh, look how the headlamp lights up the ground.
Very green.
With all the weeds. Now I'm really curious to see what the embankment and stuff will look like at night. I'm not imagining very good because there's no lighting over here and there shouldn't need to be, but I don't know, still looks sort of semi-decent. Would look better with an engine going over it.
Oh, Jesus, that was long.
Such a photogenic section.
I know, right? I'm jealous of that section.
Even at night.
Serious question for you, Tom.
Oh, what, from Serlev? It's the Exeter King Wear 3D weather pattern, cloudy with fluffy clouds, and it's set at 10 o'clock at night. The signal was green. What? Right, seriously, George, slow the fuck down.
No.
We are number 7, hey.
Yeah, let's not have a crash at the end of the stream. We already have one of those.
I've already had several crashes today.
Yeah, crash dumps and crashes.
I think we're set to go to the correct place at Barbourne North, and then that's it for this stream.
Yeah.
But tune in about, well, probably 10-15 minutes for another stream. We're going to be doing Wreckfest. So we have moved... We've done pretty well. We're at the end of the stream. And we ran with George Stevenson without any problems, really.
Yeah.
Winnie cartoons, yay!
Aaron, don't forget to squish and flick the shit out of your wand! Like this! Yeah!
Aww.
I'm gonna throw a dart at my mirror and see if it cracks. It didn't.
Chris, stop.
What?
Just stop being naughty.
Stop it, Chris. Stop.
Ron, what if I can't keep it up? I'm so nervous.
Oh man, doesn't it look good with a light on that track?
Oh my god. It actually looks like track.
Does it?
It's very attractive. Kill me, please.
Okay.
Well, that guy, me and Anthony didn't even bat an eyelid about it.
Yeah, I was like, what?
Wait, no, I didn't mean it! Bang!
Chris was resurrected 10 years later. No one remembers
him. So, everyone, that was a run from Merecombe to Barbourne with a bit of extra at the end, so... Hopefully everyone enjoyed that. I'm not even going to bother trying to drive away to play this off because I'll be driving straight into a wall. Not a wall, buffers. So, that's me, Chris and Anthony out for this part. Tune in a little while and we'll be going to be doing some Wreckfest. So, good night for this part of the stream, everyone.
Bye.
Bye.